that we want to prove that S squared, this triplet configuration, if we take one configuration out of it, it will be the eigenfunction of S squared with n eigenvalue 2 h bar squared. And we got it. Now, back home, you can calculate that S squared, when operates on state this one, instead of 1, 0, you take 1, 1. What eigenvalue it gives you? It is also an eigenstate. It is also an eigenfunction of S squared. So you apply this one on 1, 1 and check that what eigenvalue it is giving to you. You can apply S squared on 1, minus 1 and check what eigenvalue it is giving to you. If you have any difficulty in calculating this one, you can discuss with me. Clear? Now, these all the three states, the triplet states, we have calculated. Now, what about the singlet state? Means, what will be the result of 0, 0? Is the very first thing, is this will be an eigenfunction of S squared? Is the triplet configuration, all the states in the triplet configuration were the eigenfunctions of S squared? Whether the singlet configuration or the singlet state, we are leaving only one configuration in this. Whether this will be an eigenfunction of S squared? Why not? Yes, this will also be an eigenfunction of S squared. But what will be the eigenvalue? What eigenvalue we will get here? That we will have to find out. That what eigenvalue we will have here. So, we can start with this one. The only difference of this state with this state is the minus symbol. So we have already calculated this one. We have calculated this one. Only thing we will put minus sign here. So come back to this result. And what it will be when S square operates on 0, 0 here. Then what we will get? We will get the value of first do calculate to find out this thing. We will first calculate this term. Clear? So it will be S1 dot S2 and it will be S1 dot S2 and it is applied on 0, 0. So what it will be? It will be h bar square over 4, 1 over 2 will come here from this one. And what's the value of this one? Because it is up and down. Down and up, only minus sign will be replaced here. So look there, what we will get? It will be two times down, up, minus, up and down. The only thing here between this and this will be this symbol. We will make this minus, right? There is no other difference. So, two, this down, up, minus, up, down, then it will be minus and it will be 2 and up, down, and this minus will become plus because minus is here, so it is plus and down, up. And now look here, that what you will get, h bar square over 4 is there. This is 2 down and up, and this one is 1 down and up. So it is becoming 3, right? 2 down up, 1 down up. So it is becoming 3. Here, minus 2 up down and minus 1 up down. So again it is becoming 3. You can take 3 as common. So it will be 3 h bar square over 4 and then 1 over 2 down and up. So this one, it is, let me do it. What it will be? 2 and because we will maintain the minus sign here. So 2 times it will be 2 down and up. So it is 3 down and up minus 3 up and down. I have taken 3 as common. So it is becoming down up and up down. But I want to generate my state from here. So I will have to first write up, down and then minus this one. So if I take minus 3 is common, right? So it will become minus 3 is common from this one. Then it will be up, down, minus, down, up. Clear? So I took minus 3 is common, then I got the same state back and it will be 0, 0. 1 over 2 times this. So it is 0, 0 state. And now I can go to the calculation. This is the first term. So when s square applies on 0, 0, what I will get? This and this term are the same because s square is having s1 square is 2 square. It will be the same because states are not changing there. So I will have 3 over 4 h bar square, 3 h bar square over 4 plus 3 h bar square over 4, right? Like this one. I will have minus 3 h bar square over 4. So plus 2 and minus 3 h bar square over 4. And the state is 0, 0. Now what it will be? 3 plus 3, 6 and minus 3 into 2. 6 by 4. And what you got? 6 minus 6 is 0. So you got 0 and your state. So the eigen value that you got here, this thing is equal to 0. So you operated s square. When you operate, it is an eigen function of it with an eigen value 0. When s is equal to 1, you are having for one state the eigen value 2 h bar square. Now I am telling you means directly for this state you got 2 h bar square. The value that you will get for this one will be minus for this one. Here you got the eigen value as s is equal to 0 here, m is equal to 0 here. Your eigen value of s square also came out to be 0. Clear? So you can practice this thing. You can practice this thing back home, that what are the other possibilities. Means S square, this is the eigenfunction of S square. With an eigenvalue, you can calculate this one. You can calculate this one as well. We were having a composite system. We got a composite system. And this composite system was like one, it was a hydrogen atom. There were two particles involved, two spin half particles were involved, and we wanted to find out the total spin angular momentum. What we got? We got one situation, in one it was coming out to be spin one, and in the other situation we got spin zero. The system for which we got spin 1, there were three possible configurations. One was 1, 1, the other was 1 and 0, right? And the third was 1 minus 1. So inside the S equal to 1 total spin angular momentum, we got triplet state. We got three states inside their one state. And when it was, the total spin was coming out to be zero, we got only one configuration, and that was the singlet configuration. Singlet means one configuration. And for both of this triplet and singlet, we proved that they are eigenstates, eigenfunctions of S square with different eigenvalues. Out of the triplet, we calculated for this one. And we got that for this one, it is 2 h bar square. We calculated for the singlet and we came out that the eigenvalue is 0. So we were having S1 and S2, two spins, S1 and S2. So in the maximum spin that came out, the maximum spin that came out is actually S1 plus S2, the maximum spin. Because half plus half will give you 1. And what was the minimum spin? S1 minus S2 means half minus half, and it came out to be 0. 1 here and 0 here. This is the maximum spin, this is the minimum spin. As we were having two spin half particles, what if we will have some other spins? Right? Like we are having some other spins, then this, the maximum will be S1 plus S2, then it will be, the minimum will be S1 minus S2. I will put absolute here. I am putting the absolute symbol because S1 minus 2 is equivalent to S2 minus S1. Right? So that will generate a negative sign, and I don't want to have that negative sign, so I put an absolute. Why? It will go from here to there in integral steps, like S1 plus S2 minus 1, then S1 plus S2 minus 2, and so on, until it reach S1 minus S2. So this will go in integral steps. And I can give you another example. If, for example, we are having two spins, like S1 is equal to, like we are having a system in which there are two particles, and two particles are such that one is having spin 3 over 2 and the other is having spin 2. So what kind of S1 is equal to 3 over 2 while the second particle is having spin equal to 2. So what will be the situation for the composite system when the two spin will be added, and let's see what it will be. The very first, the maximum spin will be the addition of them. So 3 by 2 plus 2. 2, 2 makes 4. 4 plus 3, 7. So the maximum spin we will have will be 7 by 2. The minimum possible spin will be S1 minus 2. So 3 by 2 minus 2. 2, 2 will make 4. 4 minus 3, 1.
Minus
1, but it is absolute. You can have 2 minus 3 by 2, so it will become 1 over 2 plus. So the minimum spin will be 1 over 2. The maximum spin of the system, of the composite system, 2 particle system, will be 7 by 2. The least spin or the minimum spin will be 1 over 2. And now think of this, that it will go in integral steps, means 7 by 2 minus 1. So 7 minus 2 will make this 5 by 2. Then minus 2, 5 by 2 minus 2, 7 by 2 minus 2, it will be 3 by 2. 7 by 2 minus 3, 1 by 2. So the minimum is reached. So for such a system, we will have the S1 plus S2 combination is the possible spins will be this one. The possible spins will be this one. And what will be the probability of getting a given spin? What will be the probability of getting this much spin? This much, and this much. We will have to further work this out. And in the next lecture, we will go on with the means we will start again from the composite system. We will discuss this and then we will move to another system. Finally, we will go for any system and how many spins will be possible, and this will give rise to the Clebsch, okay, to the SCH, the Clebsch-Gordan coefficients, and we will generate a table, Clebsch-Gordan coefficients, we will generate a table, and in your book you can see that a table is given, some portions are highlighted, and we will discuss this table. We will discuss then how these coefficients are derived, and that will be our final lecture on the spin.